the entertainment bullseye every week with her Hard Riding. Straight Shooting. And Suspense.
Up the justice guns and vowed never to use them again. That was many years ago, and except for cleaning, those guns have been in the case since the day I retired.
Gee, Clay, you must have been about the best shot in the whole world, even better than Annie.
Oh, Tag, I'll never be the shot that Clay was. A pupil can't outshoot his teacher.
Experience was my teacher, Annie. Years have taught me a lot. The most important thing I learned was that when a man can draw fast and shoot straight, he doesn't have to kill.
Time was, though, when a gun was judge, jury, and executioner.
Strange talk for a man of your peaceable nature, Frank. You never held a gun in your life.
One gunfighter in the family's enough, Doctor. I figured if I never picked up a gun, I'd never get shot.
Well, that's pretty good figuring, Frank. But if your brother had felt the same, this territory would be run by outlaws instead of honest folk.
Gee, Clay, don't you miss wearing the justice guns?
No, son. They did their job, and I'll never wear them again. Not that I couldn't handle them as good as ever, understand. Now, regardless of what the doc here says.
You're not a young man anymore, Clay. Time brings a lot of changes. All I tried to tell you was that...
I know what you're trying to tell me. You doctors are all alike. A man adds a few birthdays to his life and you think he's ready to fall apart.
Now, Clay, nobody said anything about you falling apart. The doctor here is just concerned about your eyes.
We're all concerned, Clay. If you'd only submit to an operation.
I'll submit to nothing. My eyes are as good as ever and my hand just as steady. And will be until the day I die. So let's hear no more about it.
Clay, we're all your friends. We only want you.
It's Johnny Storm and Murdoch Brothers who robbed the association office.
His eyes fixed.
Stay here with him, Lofty.
Both if she shoots. I said unload.
save your strength, mister. You've still got to go up that hill and start a long walk back to jail.
Work, Annie.
Looks like you caught yourself a heifer.
The wrong one, though. The other's got away with the money. How's Clay? Is he all right?
Oh, sure. His spell passed just as quick as it came. He's okay.
Now, wait a minute. I've got my...
Your citizen's rights. You know how we know about it.
Did they get all the money, Lofty? The operation fund and everything?
Every penny of it, Annie. We won't have to worry about talking Clay into anything now. The money the townsfolk donated for that eye specialist is gone. No money, no operation.
There will be an operation. We've got to get it back.
Johnny Storm's no easy mark, Annie. He's one of the deadliest killers in the West.
Well, you don't have to come along, Mr. Craig. I'll go alone. If I had enough daylight, I'd start tracking right now.
Golly, sis, don't you worry none. You know I'll help.
Well, if you'd use that pretty blonde head of yours, you know I will, too.
Oh, I'm sorry, Lofty. It's just that I'm so worried about Clay.
I'm the one that should apologize, Annie. I know what he means to you.
I sure don't get it. Why did everyone want to keep the operation fund a secret from Clay in the first place? Doesn't he want to get fixed up?
Of course he does, Tag, but Clay Griffin is a very proud and courageous man. He's a legend in these parts. And legends just don't fall ill. His pride won't let him believe he's not the same man he was many years ago.
And how are you going to talk him into having the operation? Even if you do get the money back.
I'll make him have it, even if I've got to hold him down. The important thing right now is the money. We've got to get it back.
Well, I'll see what I can get out of the prisoner. Maybe he'll tell us where his brother and Johnny Storm are headed.
Oh, it's no use, Lofty. I tried all the way back into town.
No harm in trying again.
Save your breath, Deputy. I got nothing to tell you or anyone else.
He's not the talkative sort. We'll just have to track.
All right, Annie, you get some sleep. I'll see you at sunup.
Right, Lofty. We'll be ready.
I'll be ready.
Oh, Annie. We never get to do anything exciting around here.
Well, we can't all leave, Tag. Somebody's got to stay here and watch the prisoner.
Yeah, I never thought of that.
Things while we're gone?
Nobody else, boy, as long as Uncle Luke's out of town. I figure somebody's got to be acting sheriff.
Sure enough.
Hello, Lofty. All set?
The horses are waiting.
Good. Keep your eye on him, Tag.
Don't you worry none. I'll watch him like a hawk.
Some hawk.
Well, anyway, I'll watch him.
Morning, Annie. Lofty, I was just...
Shh. I didn't want Tag to hear you. He's all puffed up with pride when he's acting like a sheriff.
Keep an eye on things, Jim. Don't let Tag know you're around.
Sure, Lofty, I understand.
Making it easy, Johnny.
Yeah. Come on. Let's bust Al out of jail before the whole town wakes up.
Morning, Frank. How you feeling, Clay?
Oh, just fine, thanks, Jim.
Can't keep a tough old wire like him down.
What are you doing out so early?
Annie asked me to stick around the office. She and Lofty are out tracking Johnny Storm.
Well, who's in with the prisoner?
Little Tag. He's having quite a time. Tag.
Sure, be good practice for the boy.
You two out for your constitutional, are you?
Yep.
Yes, sir, wouldn't miss it for the world.
Morning like this makes a man glad to be alive.
Quite agree with you there, Frank. As soon as I've had a cup of coffee to pull my eyes away.
Well, looks like the cafe's opened up now.
It is, right enough.
Well, we'll join you on our way back, Jim.
Fine.
You wait here, Dave. I'll spring Al out of that cell in no time. Sit quiet, mister, and drop those keys. Sit tight, Al. I'll have you free just as soon as Sonny Boy here hands me the keys.
You're not gonna get them.
Come on. Hand me the keys. Hand me the
keys. What's going on here?
Watch out, Clay!
Where's Al?
Quit talking and start riding, or we'll have a whole town on our backs. Come on, let's go.
Someone get the doc. I'll ride out and get Annie and Lofty.
He'll be all right, Clay. He'll be all right.
He never picked up a gun, so he wouldn't get shot.
How's Frank? Where is he?
I don't know, Annie. Clay and the doctor are in there with him.
I've done everything possible, Clay. From here on, it's out of our hands.
Oh, Clay,
he's got a 50-50 chance, Annie. From now on, we can only wait and pray. There's nothing you can do in there, Clay.
Why don't you sit down and get some rest? I know how you feel, Clay. But we won't rest until we get Johnny Storm.
Can't keep getting away forever.
Can't you get anything out of that fellow you've got in jail, Lofty?
Murdoch? No, and it's too bad. If we could make him talk, we might be able to locate Johnny Storm.
Dust his guns! Oh, Clay, you can't.
Don't be a fool, Clay. Johnny Storm's a deadly killer.
So are the Coltons.
You're committing suicide.
I can still outshoot any murdering outlaw. Talk won't bring Storm in, but the justice guns will.
Clay, you're thinking back 30 years.
Right now, Doc, I'm thinking back further than that. I'm thinking back to the day that Frank was born. Tag, saddle up my horse and bring him around to the sheriff's office.
Do as he says, Tag.
Clay. We don't even know where Johnny Storm is.
Well, I'm gonna find out right now. I'm just gonna ask you once, mister. Where's Johnny Storm?
Go away, old man. I got no answers for you.
Answer these, then.
You wouldn't. You can't shoot me down like a caged animal. Rockville! He's in Rockville!
Clay, Rockville's an outlaw town. You can't go alone. You'll need help.
The justice guns are all the help I need.
Still Clay Griffin, Annie. Nothing will stop him now.
That's why I didn't try. The knowledge that he can't fight this battle alone would kill him just as quick as Johnny Storm's bullets. Come on, Lofty. We've got to get to Rockville before Clay does. We can cut through Langdon's property.
That ought to do it. We'll cut off 2 miles.
Sorry, folks, no vacancies.
You will have. Which room's Johnny Storm in?
I don't know him, Deputy. And I ain't in the information business.
Make it your business.
203. He's in 203. Upstairs, left.
Stand quiet, Storm. You won't live another second.
Get his gun. All right, where's the money?
It's your party, lady.
Watch him, Lofty. Here it is.
Looks like the party's over, lady.
The clerk downstairs said you had company, Johnny.
Yeah, it sort of surprised me.
That's not the only surprise you got coming. There's an old coot in town, gunning for you.
What?
Yeah. Claims he's Clay Griffin. Wants to swap shots with you. At 4 o'clock, he says. He's out there now, big as life. Say he used to be a quick gun, Johnny.
Yeah. He used to be.
Oh, you can't. He's an old man. His eyes are bad.
Look, lady, he come looking for a fight, and where he's going, he don't need no eyes. Watch these two, Dave. I gotta keep a 4 o'clock appointment.
All right. Get up. Get over and sit against that door. You. Stand over there beside him. Thank you.
Here I am, old man. Come and take me.
And use it. I didn't believe I could handle his kind alone, did you, Annie?
I never doubted it for a minute, Clay.
I'm deputizing you two men. Hold these men in your jail until I come after them.
Clay, they sent me to try and stop you, Clay. Frank's all right. He's gonna live. The doctor said the crisis is over.
I guess I kind of sold the doc short.
He's a great guy.
That he is.
Well, if you think he's such a great guy, Clay, then why don't you listen to him about the operation?
Yeah, maybe he's right after all.
Of course he is.
He could be right about a couple things. You know, Annie, I shot both justice guns at Storm and only hit him once. Maybe I am getting old.
With her hard riding. Straight shooting. And suspense.
Outside has changed in 10 years' time. It's not going to be easy starting over.
No, sir, I don't suppose it will be.
I'm not going to give you a lecture. You're an intelligent man. During the years you've been here, I've learned to know you pretty well. You're not the sort to make the same mistake twice.
You can be sure of that, sir.
I've written this letter to an old friend of mine. If you feel like it, you can go see him. I know he'll do whatever he can to get you started off on the right foot. He's a sheriff at Diablo.
Thank you, sir. I appreciate your confidence.
Well, goodbye, Tom. And good luck.
Goodbye, Warden.
Drop! Drop! Where are
do you think you're doing, Tag?
Watch me beat him to the jaw. Jaw! Look at that. Right through the heart. Good shooting, huh?
No, Tag. I wouldn't say that was very good shooting.
What do you mean? I shot him dead, and before he could even get his gun up.
Tag, I think it's about time you and I had a little talk about guns. In the first place, you don't use them to go around killing people.
Well, that's what they're for, aren't they?
Well, if I didn't know you so well, young man, I'd say you weren't very bright. An expert uses a gun to protect lives, not to take them. It's a defense weapon, Tag, now remember that.
Well, how are you going to defend yourself if some varmint draws on you without you beating to it and killing first?
I'll show you. Pull that rope.
Gosh!
See what I mean?
Sure! Sheriff!
Oh, Annie, is your uncle here?
No, he isn't, Mr. Willits. He's out of town on business, but his deputy's around here somewhere. Something wrong?
Well, I got held up again. That's what's wrong.
Oh, here's his deputy now. Lockie!
What is it, Ed?
Two men. They jumped me just this side of Eagle Rock and got away with about $8,000 worth of gold concentrate that I was bringing from the mine to the railroad station.
Have you any idea who they were? What they looked like?
Just the same as before. I couldn't tell. They wore masks. As they were going away, I took a couple of shots at him. I got the horse, and I think I nicked the other fellow's hat. Leastwise, it fell off.
Did you get his hat?
No, I couldn't. About this time, the first zombie cuts loose, and I had to take cover. And he keeps on shooting until the other fellow gets his hat, and I turns it off into the rocks on foot.
Still on foot. We got a good chance to catch him.
Any men want to come along?
Get a horse, Ed.
Why, sure.
It's gonna have to walk or this horse is gonna drop dead on us.
Well, I'm not walking. Not in this heat, I ain't.
Well, if you think I'm...
Hey, wait a minute.
Stay here, Jim. Get down. I said get down. Next time I'll shoot 6 inches lower. Get going. I know that hombre from someplace. I know that face.
Well, let's get moving.
All about?
This is one of them, all right. Look at that bullet hole I put through his hat.
Where's your partner?
What partner? I don't have any partner. I was held up back there on the trail and the fellow stole my horse. I don't know what you fellows are talking about. I was on my way to Diablo to see the sheriff.
You're going to Diablo, all right, and you're going to see the sheriff.
I don't know what it is you fellows think I did, but whatever it is, you're wrong.
Maybe, but I don't think so.
Now, wait a minute. Don't everybody go getting excited. Lofty will find them.
He'd better find them. This thing is getting kind of regular. $30,000 worth of gold in the last month.
Gosh, $30,000 worth of gold. What do you suppose those two bandits are going to do with it, Annie?
It's a good question, Tag. Something I'd like to find out myself.
Maybe they ain't look.
I think it's about time you and I did a little detective work on our own. Come on, Tag. Hi, Phil.
Hi, Phil.
Hello, Annie. Hi, Tag.
Say, Phil, do you know anyone around here shipping gold concentrate besides the Apex mine?
Oh, there ain't much going out of here anymore. Hey, the Bolton boys are shipping some.
Dan and Jim Bolton?
Yeah.
I thought their diggings played out a long time ago.
What's on your mind, Annie?
Just curious. Thanks, Phil.
All right, Annie.
Bet I know what you're thinking.
I'll bet there isn't a grain of gold in the Bolton mine. Come on, we're going out there and have a look around.
Light.
You stay here, Tag. And keep watch. I'm gonna have a look inside that mine.
Right.
Jim. Now I remember him. Malloy. That's who he is, Tom Malloy.
What are you talking about?
The guy I took this horse off of, Tom Malloy. We did time together about 5 years ago.
What do you reckon he's doing out here?
I don't know. He's doing a long stretch for safe robbery. I thought he was still up there.
What are you taking the saddle off that horse for?
We gotta get rid of it. I don't want anything around here that'll tie us up with Malloy.
That's a good idea.
But we could keep the saddle. No use in losing that. I'll hide it where nobody will find it.
Maybe you know you're trespassing on private property.
That's right. But I was just looking for the two men who held up the gold messenger.
What made you think you'd find them around here?
Just a hunch, maybe.
Yeah, we thought they might be hiding in that mine.
Well, why don't you go ahead and have a look?
I've already had a look. Tag, go get the horses. It's kind of dangerous to turn your back around here.
Don't try it.
I'd like to get a shot at them, too.
There'll be other chances.
Sure?
What do you mean by that?
I thought Dan Bolton and his brother were mixed up in this thing somewhere.
Why Dan Bolton?
Well, I'll explain it while I make us some coffee. Come on.
Of all the crazy ideas I ever heard of, you going up to the Bolton mine, you could have gotten yourself killed.
Well, Lofty, I do believe you worry about me.
Well, of course I do. But that's got nothing to do with it. You could have gotten Tag killed, too.
Well, at least I gave that mine a good looking over. I don't believe there's a grain of gold in that place.
Look, Annie, nobody can tell if there's gold in a mine by just walking in and taking a quick look around.
Well, then where are they getting the stuff they're shipping out? Tell me that.
Annie, the man we got locked up in there has been identified by Ed Willits. He's even got the hole in his hat that Ed put there.
Well, it could be a coincidence. I still don't think we've got the right man.
But he admits being in prison for robbery. Gives us some story about the warden writing your Uncle Luke a letter, only he can't produce the letter.
But he explained that the letter was in the saddlebag on the horse they took from him.
Oh, the whole story sounds too fishy. I'm sorry, Annie, I just don't believe it.
Oh, Lofty, your only trouble is you're just as stubborn as a mule.
I am not. It's just that...
so. You got an idea set in your head and you just don't want anyone to change it.
Now, look, Annie, you know that isn't so.
Then why don't you send the warden a telegram and check?
All right, I'll do that.
Miss Annie?
Yes?
I heard you mention Dan Bolton a while ago.
Yes, do you know him?
We were in prison together. He served out his time and got out about 5 years ago.
Well, that's about the length of time he's been around here.
That fellow that took my horse, there was something familiar about him. I seemed to recognize his voice.
Are you sure?
Sure, I'm sure, and it was Dan Bolton. I could swear to that.
Look, with your prison record, you're in a tough spot unless we can prove somebody else held up that gold messenger. Will you help me? Will you do anything I ask?
Yes, ma'am.
I'll be right back. Oh, Bert!
Annie, what can I do for you?
Well, I've got a story for your paper.
Good, what is it?
Well, you can say this. It has just been disclosed that the man who's being held for the holdup of the Apex Mine Messenger is Tom Malloy. who recently escaped from prison while serving a term for robbery.
An ex-convict, eh? Hey, that is a good story.
Will it be in tomorrow's paper?
It certainly will, and right on the front page. Thanks to you, Annie.
You're welcome, Mr. Copler. Goodbye.
Bye.
Ow! Oh, Tag, hold still. I'll be through in a minute.
Oh, Annie, for gosh sakes.
Just a couple of more pins.
Hello, Annie.
Good morning.
How do you do, madam? Oh, it's Tag. Hey, that's very becoming.
That sells it. I won't do it.
Oh, Tag, now look what you've done. I'm going to have to fit this all over again.
Not on me, you won't.
Oh, please, Tag, it'll only take a minute.
I have to take breakfast to your prisoner. Why don't you try it on Lofty? He's bigger than me.
Hey, that's a good idea.
Oh, no. Say, have you seen the morning's paper?
No, not yet.
Take a look. The man we got locked up in there escaped from state prison.
No, really?
Now, you see, Annie, a man's judgment is better in things like this. Why, I knew he wasn't telling the truth from the minute we nailed him.
I'm sorry I argued with you, Lofty. I should have known that you're much smarter about such things than I am.
Oh, I didn't mean that, Annie, and you know it. You're plenty smart about a lot of things. But dealing with crooks is a man's job, and you can't be sentimental.
That's right. And I suppose that's why you're such a good deputy sheriff.
Lofty! Your prisoner escaped!
What?
When I came to bring him his breakfast, that cell door was wide open.
I guess it's kind of my fault.
Kind of your fault. What do you mean?
Well, I think I left the cell door unlocked last night.
You deliberately let him go? Well, Annie, I hope you realize what you've done. You made me the laughingstock of the whole town. That man escaped from state prison.
Lofty, I'd like to explain about it.
You'll have to explain about it later. Right now, I have to go out and find Tom Malloy all over again.
Gee, Lofty's mad, Annie. I've never seen him act like that before.
You'll get over it. Go in and eat your breakfast, Tag.
Okay,
it's Annie.
Everything's all set. You sure you know what you're doing?
Yes, ma'am. I thought it all out.
Good. Good luck to you, and be careful.
Thanks, Miss Annie. I'll bring back that letter that the warden gave me.
Sure did. I got some information, too.
You know that Tom Malloy you're taking the horse off of? He wasn't released from state prison. He busted out.
Yeah?
Yeah, and you want a real laugh? They got him locked up in the Diablo jail for robbing the gold messenger.
Well, this ought to take some of the heat off of us. You know, I was kind of suspicious of that guy. When I knew him 5 years ago, he still had 15 years to serve. So he busts out, huh?
Yeah, but it didn't do him much good. Caught up with him again.
Howdy. Wonder if I could hit you up for a little grub. I got money to pay for it.
Well, if it isn't Tom Malloy.
You made a mistake, stranger. My name is Smith.
Cut it out, Tom. I'm Dan Bolton. Remember me?
Well, I'll be dogged if it ain't. Dan Bolton, how are you?
This is my brother, Jim.
Hello, Jim.
Howdy. I heard they had you locked up in the Diablo jail.
You don't think I'm going to let any two-bit jail hold me after breaking out of state prison, do you? It's a nice, quiet layout you got here. Maybe we can do a little business.
Yeah, what kind of business?
Like I say, I got a little money and need a place to hide out.
Sure, why not?
Wait a minute, Dan. Are you crazy? They're looking for this guy.
Tom's an old friend. You don't think I'd turn down an old friend, do you? Take care of your horse back at the corral there, Tom. We'll rustle up some grub.
What's the idea of letting an escaped convict hole up here? He's going to get us into a mess of trouble.
Take it easy. We can use this guy. He's one of the best safe experts in the country. And with what we've got on him, he'll have to do anything we say.
Well, I still don't like it.
Jim, we've got a pretty good setup here, Tom, if you'd like to string along with us.
Nah. I don't know anything about mining.
It isn't hard to learn the way we do it.
What do you mean? Shut up. You talk too much.
Tom's okay. Stop worrying about him, Jim.
What's the deal?
Well, we've got a gold mine, you see. Only there isn't any gold in it.
Two claims.
So?
Some of the mines around here have got lots of gold. They ship the concentrate down to the railroad station. But on the way, they're relieved of it.
I'm beginning to understand.
Gold concentrate isn't easy to get rid of. That is, unless you've got a gold mine yourself. Then it's easy. It just comes out of your own mine.
Pretty smart. I wouldn't mind being in on a deal like that.
You never could learn to keep your mouth shut, Dan. That's why you had to spend 5 years of your life in the pen.
Relax, Jim, relax.
So what's your idea?
Well, when Jim went into town this morning, he found out there's another shipment going out early tomorrow morning, right after daylight.
Being Sunday, they don't figure to be bothered, right?
That's right. We can knock them over in Sidewinder fast. They won't be expecting us there.
Sounds okay. Count me in.
Well, it means an early start. Better turn in.
In here?
Right.
Good night. Good
night.
Coffee on the stove.
You're not going to square yourself with a pot of coffee. I've been out combing those hills since early this morning. Annie, how could you have done such a crazy thing? What's your uncle going to say?
Well, if it works out the way I think it's going to, he'll say I'm pretty smart. Want to hear about it?
No, but I'll have the coffee.
Wait, Lofty, you'll see I'm right.
Trouble with you, Annie, is you're too trusting. Malloy's probably miles away from here by now. We'll never see him again.
What's the matter?
Keep talking, but don't look toward the window.
Sorry, ma'am.
What were you doing out there?
Waiting for her to be alone so I could come in and talk to her.
What happened, Tom?
Well, I went up to the Boltons, all right.
Well, did you get the warden's letter?
I couldn't find my horse or my saddlebags.
Still sounds fishy to me.
I don't blame you for that. You've been right all along, Miss Annie. They're your men, all right.
You mean they've been pulling these holdups?
Every last one of them. Not only that, but they got another one planned for tomorrow morning.
Well, I'll go up and bring them in.
No, wait a minute, Lofty. You haven't got any evidence yet. You got to catch him in the act.
Yeah, that's right. You know where they're going to hold this messenger up?
At a place called Sidewinder Pass. They found out he's going through there tomorrow morning at daybreak.
Well, I'll be there before daybreak. You go back to the cabin. I'll round up some men.
Well, there's nothing in any of this stuff that'll tell us anything. The only thing I can figure out is Malloy took off because he was afraid we'd turn him in.
Yeah, you fool mighty easy, Dan. I found this letter in his saddlebag. It's from the prison warden to the sheriff in Diablo.
Well, he didn't bust out. He was released, huh?
That's right. He's a plant. He's working for the sheriff. And you had to talk your fool head off to him.
They ought to have been here by now, Lofty. You don't reckon that Malloy double-crossed you?
No, I don't think so.
Well, they might have got the messenger farther up.
No, they couldn't have. Got the road covered all the way to the mine.
Well, maybe they'll be along.
This way, Tom.
Are we going to Sidewinder Pass? It's that way.
We changed our plans.
Yeah, we forgot to tell you. We're going to knock over the bank in Diablo.
But it's Sunday. Won't that be closed?
Yeah, we figured on that. But you're pretty good at cracking safes. We got everything you'll need right here.
It's almost time for Sunday school, and you're not even dressed yet.
Wait a minute, sis. Those two Bolton brothers just rode in town, and you're escaped prisoners with them.
Are you sure?
Sure, I'm sure. I saw him.
Look, Tag, I want you to ride out to Sidewinder Pass as fast as you can and get hold of Lofty.
Sure, sis.
All set.
You'll be taken care of when this thing blows.
Then when this thing goes off, the whole town's here. We gotta be ready to make a fast getaway.
Now you go out and get the horses and bring them around the front. Wait there.
I was right about the warden's letter. I just found it on him. Come on.
Hey, Eddie, I met Lucky right out at the edge of town.
Good work, Tag. Now hurry along and get dressed or Sunday school's gonna be over. Go on.
What was the answer to the telegram I sent the prison warden?
Yeah, what does it say?
Listen, and if you need a new deputy to send to Red Rock District, I believe Tom Malloy would be a good man for the job.
That telegram came a little bit late, didn't it?